Welcome to PC Mac. Today we are talking about how we can set up a free VPN account and use it for lifetime. So let's do it. Before we start, I would like you to go ahead and click on the subscribe button. It's free and you can just go ahead and click on the bell icon for my latest videos. So let's get started. So guys, if you are new to my website, you can check out my other video as well, how to set up the free VPN account. You will see the link right now on the top right corner. This is a new video, and in this video I'm talking about a different website through which we can connect to a free VPN server and use our computer over the internet without being traced by any other government or any other company. So first thing what we need to do is need to download the OpenVPN client. So we need to go into OpenVPN and we need to go into the download section, and as we are using a Windows 7 machine, as you can see, we will go ahead and download from here the exe file. It will take a moment to download. So in between the download is going on, let's go ahead and show you what's my IP address right now. So right now here is my IP address, as you can see. So once we set up our VPN account on OpenVPN, that is the client tool through which we will go ahead and configure our OpenVPN. This is our client tool which is right downloaded now. Let's go ahead and open it, and yes, and let's go and install it. I agree. Next, install. So always trust software from OpenVPN technology. Let's go and install it. So as you can see, the installation for OpenVPN is complete. The client is installed now. We need to click on next and finish. It will open a file that contains all the information how you can configure it. You can go through this file. Let me just go ahead and close it. And the first thing you need to do is open your OpenVPN. So when you type open in search box, you will see OpenVPN right here. You need to right click and then run as administrator. Click on yes. Once you do that, as you can see, no readable connection profile. We didn't create any profile right now, so we need to send all the information to these folders, OpenVPN config or C program file OpenVPN config. So right now we need to download the config file. So let's go and click on OK. It will be down here, as you can see. Right now it's waiting for the connection. You will see a white logo right now because it's not connected. So let's go ahead and open our website through which we will go ahead and download the configuration file for our OpenVPN. So the website is right here. I made a bookmark for it. Let's go ahead and open it. So the name of the website is vpnbook.com. This is the website from where we need to download all the information, all the configuration files. So we are using OpenVPN as our client to connect to the OpenVPN server. So we'll go right here. And if you want to purchase a dedicated VPN, you can also go here. And as you can see, 7.95 per month, 30 days money back guarantee. So these are the dedicated servers. And for like normal things, you can go and download OpenVPN files from here. So let's go ahead and download some files. So we will go with server 3, the US one. Let's go ahead and download one from Europe, one from US, one from Canada, one from here, and one from here. And as you can see, the username and the passwords are right here, so you need to write it down somewhere. So let's go ahead and do it on a notepad. Let's copy and paste the username and password. So the username and the password is right here, and all the files are downloaded successfully. Let's just go ahead and open it. So let's go ahead and open, first of all, extract these files. So it's right here. So here are four files, as you can see. One is for TCP 80 port, another one is TCP 443 ports, then UDP 53 port, UDP 2500 port. So I recommend you to use UDP ports because they are more secure than TCP one. Let me just show you where you need to paste these files. I have already copied these files. Let me just do it again. Copy. We need to go into C, then program file. We will see a folder created here with the name OpenVPN. You need to open it, and then we need to go into config folder and just paste all the files here. So for this spectacle, I'll try to connect to all of these one by one and check what it make difference to our network. Let me just minimize this, and let's first of all open what's my IP. So as you can see right here, the IP address. Let me go ahead and open another tab and try to connect to the VPN now by right click, and as you can see, we have pasted all these four VPN config file in our config folder. So we will try to connect to this one. Let's try to connect, and once you try to connect it, it will ask for the username and the password. So we have already copied it, copy, then paste, and the password, copy, paste. We can save the password here as well. Let's click on OK and let's check whether it's connected or not. So once it's connected, you will see a green signal here, like a green light on the VPN. So we are connected now. Let's check what's my IP now. So we are connected now to our VPN, and as you can see, the IP is changed. I didn't refresh the first page, so the IP is 103, now it's 198. So let's check what's the location it's giving us. So right now my browser is taking my old location, as you're not able to see it. But let me go to a different website to show you. So we have used US IP addresses, US configuration file, as you can see, US1. So it might take us to US location. Let's check. As you can see, United States, Virginia. So the location is right here. Let's try to refresh the location from Google as well. I use a tool, cleanup, to clean all my computer cache and everything. So let's do it. Now let's just refresh it one more time. Let me just close it and try it on a different browser. So as you can see, we will check on Bing Maps and check what's the location right now it's getting. So as you can see here, United States. So the location is keep on changing. It's right now in Abu Dhabi, Dubai. As you can see the location. Let's try to connect to a different server and then check. Let's try to connect to this one. We need to go with the same password. Let's first disconnect from the old one and then try to connect to this one. So it's also connected now. Let's check. Let's try to refresh the page. Let's close this one and try in a different web browser, Firefox. So as you can see, we are able to connect to this server, United States, Virginia. Let's try one more server. Let's go to downloads and then let's check this one. So the method is same. You need to go into config folder and paste all your configuration files right here, as you can see, and then it will be automatically detected here. So let's try this one now. First of all, let's disconnect from here and then we'll try to connect to a different server. This one, connect. Again, it asks for the username and the password. Let's save it. It's connected. Let's check on Firefox what's the new location now. So right now it shows us that we are in Germany and the IP address is also changed, 172.162.193.233. So let me just close it. So guys, you can also go ahead and check this VPN service from VPN book. It's totally free. You can use it. You can download as many files as you want and to try to connect them one by one. If you face any problem, you have the comment section. You can write down in the comment section. I'll try to help you. And if you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye-bye. Take care.